In this video, we're going to finish the Properties of Exponents worksheet, easy, on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. Now, in the first video for this worksheet, we went over the product rule. In this video, we're going to be dealing with the quotient rule, which has a similar concept. So a to the x divided by a to the y is going to be equal to a to the x minus y. So we're going to be subtracting those. So if we were to multiply, we would add. However, since we're dividing with these exponents, we're going to be subtracting. If you need to see it in fraction form, it's a to the x over a to the y. That's equal to a to the x minus y. So looking at number 21, we have r squared over 2 times r to the third. So pulling that 2 out, but leaving it in the denominator, we'll have 1 half times r squared over r cubed, which we will write as 1 half times r to the 2 minus 3, which is 1 half times r to the negative 1. And remembering that negative exponent rule, we will put 1 over r to the positive 1. So this will be 1 half times 1 over r to the positive 1, which is equal to 1 over 2r for number 21. And number 22, splitting up this fraction, I'll pull out that 4, so I'll have 1 fourth, and I'll be multiplying that to x to the negative 1 over x to the fourth. So I'll write this as 1 fourth times x to the negative 1 minus 4, which will be 1 fourth times x to the negative 5, since negative 1 minus 4 is negative 5. So that can be rewritten as 1 fourth times 1 over x to the positive 5, or 1 over x to the 5th. And simplifying again, multiplying my numerators, I'll get 1, and multiplying my denominators, I'll get 4x to the 5th. So 1 over 4x to the 5th is my solution in number 22. For number 23, I'll have 3 into the 4th over 3 into the 3rd. So I'll have 3 over 3 times into the 4th over n to the third. 3 over 3 is 1, so I'll have 1 times n to the fourth over n to the third is n to the 4 minus 3. So 1 times n to the 4 minus 3 will just be n to the 1, which we can write as the variable n. In number 24, I'll write this as 1 over 2, or 1 half, times m to the fourth over m to the fourth, which is 1 half times m to the 4 minus 4, which is 1 half times m to the 0, which any number or variable raised to a power of 0 is simply 1. So that's 1 half times 1, which is equal to 1 half. In number 25, I'll have 3 times m to the negative 4th over m to the third. So that's 3 times m to the negative 4 minus 3, which is 3 times m to the negative 7. So when I rewrite m to the negative 7 as 1 over m to the positive 7th, multiplying that by 3, I'll get 3 over m to the positive 7. And number 26, I'll have 2 over 3 times x to the fourth over x squared times y to the negative fourth over y to the negative third times z to the negative third all over z to the positive fourth. So this will be 2/3 times x to the 4 minus 2 times y to the negative 4 minus negative 3 times z to the negative 3 minus positive 4. So that's equal to 2/3 times x squared times y to the negative 4 minus negative 3 is negative 1 times z to the negative 3 minus 4, which is negative 7. So I'll rewrite this as 2/3 times x squared times 1 over y times 1 over z to the 7th, remembering my negative exponent rule. Now I'll simplify that all. Multiplying the numerators, I'll have 2 times x squared all over the denominators multiplied together, which is 3 times y times z to the 7th. And that's my solution in number 26. Now remember, x to the 0, or any number to the 0, is 1. And 4 divided by 4 is also 1. So I'll have y to the negative 2 times z to the 3rd all over x. However, I cannot have a negative exponent in my answer. So I'm just going to rewrite y to the negative 2, moving it to the denominator. So that's going to be z to the 3rd in the numerator all over y to the positive 2 times x. And that's y squared, or y to the positive 2 now, because I moved it into the denominator. So z cubed all over y squared times x. In number 28, I have 2/3 times h to the 3rd times j to the negative 3 all over j times k to the 4th all over k. So that's 2/3 times h cubed times j to the negative 3 minus 1 times k to the 4th minus 1, since j and k both have exponents of 1 in the denominator in the original expression. So now we'll have 2/3 times h cubed times j to the negative 3 minus 1, which is j to the negative 4th, and then I'm going to be multiplying that by k to the 4 minus 1, which is k to the 3rd. So my j to the negative 4th will be written in the denominator. So I'll have 2 times h to the 3rd times k to the 3rd all over 3 times j to the 4th. And that's because the 3 with the h is positive, the 3 with the k is positive, but the 4 is negative, so that j is going to be going into the denominator. I'll start by having 4/3. Then I'll have m to the 4 minus 2. So m to the 4 minus 2, and then I'll multiply that to n to the 3 minus 2. So times n to the 3 minus 2, and then I'll multiply that by p to the 3 minus 4. So p to the 3 minus 4. That's equal to 4/3 m squared times n to the first, which is n, times p to the negative 1. However, the p has a negative exponent, so I need to move it into the denominator. So that's 4 times m squared times n all over 3 times p to the first, or 3p. So I'm doing the same exact steps that I've been doing it. I've just written this a different way. I've just kept my math all in the same fraction as opposed to splitting the fraction up. Now lastly, for this worksheet, we're going to go over number 30. Before I work through this problem, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated, and they just let me know that you're finding these videos useful. So now, on to number 30. I'm going to start by simplifying. I have 2 bases where the exponent is 0. That's y to the 0 and z to the 0. Both of those will equal 1. So I'll rewrite this as 3x to the 3rd times y to the negative 1 times z to the negative 1 all over x to the negative 4. Now, I can write this as 3 times x to the 3rd minus a negative 4, since x to the 3rd is divided by x to the negative 4th, and then I'll multiply that by y to the negative 1st times z to the negative 1st. That's going to be 3 times x to the 3 minus negative 4 is x to the positive 7, and y to the negative 1st and z to the negative 1st can be written in the denominator as y to the 1st, which is y, times z to the 1st, which is z. So 3x to the 7 all over y times z is my solution in number 30. Now, quickly note, another way we could have done this problem, or another way to do quotients, is to move that negative exponent into the numerator. So remember that a to the negative x is equal to 1 over a to the positive x. So if I have 1 over x to the negative 4th in my denominator, I could write that as x to the opposite of negative 4, which is x to the 4th. So then I could have multiplied x to the 3rd times x to the 4th, which would have been x to the 3 plus 4, x to the 7th. So that just goes to show you that if I have a negative exponent, regardless of whether that negative exponent is in the denominator or the numerator, I will be able to flip it and make it positive. Now that we've finished up with this worksheet, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And remember, like, subscribe, and share.